Today we're going to give you a preview of a highly anticipated feature of HitFilm version 13, the 3D camera tracker from Foundry. HitFilm version 13 will be coming out this July, and at that time we'll release the project files for this tutorial. So be sure to bookmark this video and check back later to download those. We're also running a sale on the FXhome store right now for 25% off store-wide, so be sure to check that out and grab your discounts while they last. First, I'll put the clip into its own composite shot. This was filmed using a Ronin-S gimbal to get the smooth motion. Before we actually do the track, there's something we can do to make it more accurate. I want the camera tracker to ignore the area that Basil occupies, because he's doing his own movements and could mess up the track. To do this, we have to make a mat. Create a new plane, and using the freehand mask tool, draw a rough shape around Basil. In the controls panel, under the mask transform properties, activate keyframes for position, path, rotation, and scale. Go through the clip and adjust the mask as needed, so that it covers Basil the entire time. This is the area that the camera tracker will ignore. Once finished, we have to bake in the mask. Select the layer and choose Make Composite Shot. Choose to move the masks with the layer. Now we can begin tracking. Search in the effects panel for camera tracker. Drag the effect directly onto the video. In the controls panel, drop down the camera tracker controls. Under matte source, select matte alpha. Then choose the matte composite shot we just made. Click track features. The camera tracker will automatically go through the clip, choosing and tracking multiple points along the way. Notice how there are no points being tracked in the area of the matte I drew earlier. Once it's finished, select Solve Camera, then Create Scene. This will put a 3D camera on the timeline, which matches the motion of what we filmed. The camera tracker is going to try to figure out where the ground is, but since we know that, we can tell it directly. Highlight a few of the points on the ground and go into the menu in the viewer. This menu is only visible when the camera tracker effect is selected. Go to Ground Plane and then choose Set to Selected. You can now start putting elements into your scene. I layered some grunge on various surfaces in the clip. To do this, select the camera tracker effect so that you can see all the tracking points. Then click the point nearest to where you want to place the texture. Come down to the menu and choose Create Point. This will make a 3D point that is placed exactly on the surface. I'll bring in a picture of grunge and make it 3D. Parent it to the point, and reset the layer to place it directly onto the point itself. Come into the controls panel and use the orientation or rotation controls to align the surface correctly. Once you have that done, the texture should appear to be correctly placed in the scene. I use this same technique for the broken windows. Now for the floating ash particles. Let's bring the particle simulator down into the timeline. In the emitter properties, change the shape to cube and adjust the height, width, and depth to fit your scene. Increase the life by a few seconds so that they last longer. Lower the speed to make them slower. Decrease the time shift by a few seconds so that they're on screen from the start. In the Appearance section under Texture, choose Built-in and then Fire Ferocity 1. Let's lower the scale to a more appropriate size. Uncheck Billboard so that the particles aren't always facing the camera. Checkmark Align to Motion. To make the particles fade in and out, let's select the system and come up to the Lifetime panel. Select Alpha and change the type to Gradient. Add a black point at the beginning and end. The blue color was applied with a grade layer on top. I used a curves effect to lower both the red and green channels, then darken everything on the RGB curve. I'll also use a bleach bypass effect to crush the shadows a bit more. There were a few complications with this specific shot because of the lighting. I found that when I decreased the brightness enough to make it look like night, this piece of the sky was the only thing visible, and Basil was hidden in darkness. So I drew a mask on a black plane set to the multiply blend mode to darken it down. I then used another curves effect on a grade layer that was masked around Basil to brighten him up. Still, the scene was too dark, so I added two light flare effects on either side of the screen. I used the flashlight preset from the free lens flare pack we released not too long ago. Let me know if you have any questions about today's effect, and don't forget to check out the FXhome store for 25% off storewide. I'll see you all in the next video.